Hey guys, it's me, Natural Nikki DST, live and in living color today. I want to give a different video today. This is going to be primarily focused on the LCSW, which is a licensed clinical social worker exam that I took recently. Many people have messaged me in person or via internet, just kind of asking me like what steps I took in reference to taking and passing the exam. So I felt that I would just kind of share with you guys some of my experiences and hopefully some helpful tips that will help you pass on the first try. I owe my huge success primarily to the Therapist Development Center. It's an online program that you can purchase online. Just type in Therapist Development Center, and it's a step-by-step guide for the test. I feel like it over-prepared me for the test. I went into the test confident and ready. It has worksheets, there's audio, there's online quizzes, there's rationales to everything. And me personally, I feel like there were some questions that were very, very, very similar to the actual test. So that itself, you know, made me feel really, really comfortable. I want to say a week or 7 days before I actually took my actual exam, I did purchase the ASWB online quiz. And I took that quiz online and I actually passed. I needed 101 to pass for the online quiz, and I got 101. So that definitely like eased my anxiety, you know, that week of the test, because I was very, very nervous and anxious, you know, kind of up and down, you know, throughout the night, wondering, you know, studying, listening to audio at night, hoping that I'm like regurgitating the right information and retaining it, I guess you could say. So the week of the actual test, I didn't really study that much. I probably took maybe one or two online quizzes on the Therapist Development Center, and then I pretty much just went in there. I did a quick review, maybe about 2 or 3 hours before I took it for the exam. Went in, took the test. Definitely was kind of motivating and encouraging myself throughout the test, saying positive affirmations to myself and saying positive things like, you got this, you know this, you know, you're very, very smart, you're competent, you can do this. You know, think like a clinician, think like a supervisor, think like a textbook. And when I submitted my test, it said pass, and I was super, super, well, actually said congratulations, you passed. And I was super, super excited. It was a very surreal moment, and I'm very, very happy to say that I passed, and I can cross that off my list. But I kind of want to go back and give you a little bit more step-by-step as far as what I felt like that was encountered on the quizzes when I took them. For obvious reasons, I can't go too in detail, because I think they say that you can't discuss like what type of questions. But to be honest with you, I think I suffer from acute stress anxiety, because I literally like can't even tell you word for word like what my exact questions were. But I can give you a premise on like what kind of questions to look for. I'll definitely say look at like recall based questions. Those are kind of questions that when the questions you ask, they kind of make you think of what you ask, you know, your next action. So first and next, yada, yada, yada. Like, what do you do first? What do you do next? And they have a lot of application questions. That would be kind of very similar to the recall, but you have to apply that to some kind of scenario. Then of course they had their reasoning based questions, which would probably, they said maybe those are, you don't feel comfortable, you don't really know their the information. It's important to find out the reasoning first. So by that, it basically just means that those are kind of interesting, because they're not all the more than one could be the right answer, essentially. So I found to learn that 10% of the questions will probably be, from my understanding, they said 80 to 85% of the exam is a reasoning-based questions, followed by 10% of the exam is going to be the application questions, and then 5 to 10 will be the recall based questions. When I did the therapist development, they broke it up into like 50 super topics, which basically prepared me for the test, and I feel like even prepared me as a social worker. It allowed me to go through the entire brand new code of ethics, which includes internet-based questions, which were very similar on the quiz. So that made me feel really, really good and confident going into there, because there were a lot of ethics questions in there and case scenarios. And I think that's to be because they want to definitely make sure that we know our code of ethics, because that is our Bible as a social worker. And so there are a lot of definitely like code of ethics, but I mean, if you look at questions, you know, in general, think about our code of ethics, you know, it's very, very valid that we need to know it. That is our Bible. That is what, you know, if we ever were to go against the board and we would have to fight with, you know, trying to show that we were, you know, doing ethically what we were supposed to do as clinicians, as social workers. So I remember on my particular quiz, there were lots of questions on dealing with child abuse and neglect, elder abuse, domestic violence situations, crisis, and by crisis I mean like self-harm, suicidal, homicidal ideations, what would you do type situations. What I would say, I had, I had some substance abuse, had a couple of psychiatric disorders and personality disorders were on there, but I would say probably one or two questions of those. Had some things dealing with depression, anxiety, of course, the ADHD behavior, a little bit of grief and loss. Had some sexuality questions too, which was actually really interesting for me. Had some trauma going on, some medical conditions. Had a couple of questions dealing with like Erickson and Piaget, I would say. Some adolescent issues, some that are regular, normal adolescent behaviors versus not. Had a couple of questions, I want to say about one or two questions dealing with couples. So I found that to be pretty interesting. Some talking about like some intervention strategies, how to terminate properly with the client, medication management. What else did they have in there? Boundaries, counter transference was on there. Let's see, group. They had a couple of things on group therapy. Had a couple of questions, actually a lot of questions in my quiz, I feel like, on school therapy and things of that nature. Had a couple dealing with hospital social work. Had some case management, a couple of research, cultural competencies, which I found to be really, really interesting, were on the quiz. So, I mean, I feel like I had like an array of questions. And it's so funny because when I talked to other social workers who recently taken the test, they've all said different things. They were like, dang, I didn't have some of those questions, or I had these kinds of questions. A lot of advocacy and organization. So you really don't pretty much know. And like I said, like, I started doing some things, like this is kind of also too, like I think kind of helps me pass the test, me personally. Like, you know, I had a book, it was my study material binder. It had my first and last name, and it had future LCSW. All around my house, I was posting things about, I'm going to pass, you will pass. You know, I would take many quizzes throughout the day that took about 10 minutes. I used the LCSW pocket prep. But like I said, even though I used the LCSW pocket prep, literally the Therapist Development Center helped prepare me for that. And then I took the pocket prep to be able to properly answer the questions. Although the way the questions are set up in the LCSW pocket prep are not similar at all to the actual test, but it is still pretty knowledgeable to have and base information off of. So I'd use those informations. What else did I do? Those were the main two things that I used, to be honest with you. Therapist Development Center and the pocket prep. In addition to that, using those positive affirmations all around, saying I'm going to pass, I'm going to pass. I didn't tell anybody my exact date, except for my super, super close friends and families. And by that, I mean people who are positive and who are going to speak positivity and into my life. It's who I told. I didn't tell anybody at my job. They knew that I was taking the test, but they didn't know when. So when I actually took the test, you know, I sent it to my supervisor and she told everyone at the company, you know, so I was really excited about that. I thought they were really super sweet to show support for me in that way. So I'm very appreciative of that. What else did I do? I wrote, it sounds kind of crazy, but I actually wrote a prep letter to myself. And like, and I also made like a thank you letter, like as if I had already received my letter, I had already received my pass, and then people were congratulating me in my thank you response. And I had like a, because we live in this, you know, a day of age of technology, so I even had like an Instagram video that I was prepared to post, which I did once I passed. So it felt really, really good. Like I said, all of those things kind of like motivated, I guess essentially kind of hyped me up to do well. And I was like, Nicole, you know this, you know the information, you can do it. And like I said, my motivation to study for this stuff was like, okay, I do not want to take this test again. I only want to take it one time. And I feel so incredibly blessed and fortunate to be able to say that I took it and passed. And then for those individuals, even if you didn't pass it on the first try, don't let that discourage you. Like, you know, the ultimate goal is to just pass the test. It doesn't matter if it takes you two times, three times, five times. You know, getting rid of like that anxiety really, you know, helps. I exercised. I started eating healthier because, you know, statistics show when you eat healthy, there are certain foods that power your brain to memorize stuff. So I was doing those things. You know, I started exercising, eating healthy. Like I said, attempting to try to surround myself with positivity. Now, I had the entire program for 6 months, but was I studying for 6 months? No. I want to say I began to consistently study 5 weeks before the actual exam. What I like about the Therapist Development Center is that it also has a timeline and a check sheet that tells you what to study on what day. And they have like a check off of like how long it should take you to prepare for it. So, I mean, I was doing pretty good. I also want to say too, around question 95, I did a stretch. I stretched out. Like, you know, I couldn't actually leave the actual testing center, but you know, around like the question 95, I was kind of stretched a little bit in my chair, loosened up, and then went back in and finished up the rest of the test. And when I say went back in, I just stopped stretching because I couldn't leave. And I don't know if it's because of the adrenaline of all the anxiousness of the actual test, but a funny thing about it was that the day of the test, I was like, I couldn't sleep, so I literally woke up at like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. I didn't take my test until 8 o'clock. So, you know, I ate a nice hearty breakfast. You know, I said a prayer. Had my mom and two of my really good friends. They prayed over me that morning. I want to say then around like 6:45-ish, I drove to the location. Got there around about 7:10 or so, 7:15. I walked up to the testing center, And then I sat there. And I literally was there before the actual people who give out the exams. So that was kind of funny. So excited and anxious at the same time. Like, I didn't bring anything with me but my ID, my 2 points of ID, as well. I didn't bring in a coat, I didn't bring in my purse, I didn't bring in anything. So that was kind of funny. So Lay's like, do you have anything you want to check in? I'm like, no. And I know she was like looking at me like, this girl is crazy because it's cold outside, but I just didn't want to chance it. So I was like, nope, I'm not going to bring anything with me. They're really super strict as far as like checking everything. Like, they're checking my glasses as if I would have things in my glass. I had to lift up my sleeves and my pants leg to show them I didn't have anything in there. So that was kind of funny. They took my picture, they did fingerprints and scanning. So they were pretty serious, you know, to make sure that like I am who I say I am. So it took me exactly 3 hours to sit for that test. Three. So that was kind of interesting. So the test is actually 4 hours long, 170 questions. Of those 170 questions, so many are like screened through, you know, are pre-screened or are not scored. So then you'll find out at the end how many you need it. For me, I need 99. And the whole entire time that I was saying my prayer, I was like, Lord, I don't need overflow of scores. All I want is the exact number. If I have to have 105, give me 105. I don't need 125. Give me the exact number I need to pass. I don't need no more, no less. So I needed 99 and I got exactly 99. I did mark some questions while I was, you know, throughout the exam. But the interesting thing about it was that I didn't go back. I didn't go back and check any of them because I didn't have that aha moment. And for me, if I don't have an aha moment, I'm not changing my answers. So when they asked me at the end of the test that I want to go back and review, I was like, no. And then once I answered those 10 question service, you know, survey, it showed me, congratulations, you passed. But I did the exact same formation as far as not going back and reviewing on my on the mock exam. I will say, make sure that you answer every single question, even if you don't know it, just answer it. And kind of go from there. There were some questions that I, you know, didn't know. There were some parts throughout the exam, I was like, I don't know. Am I going to pass? Am I not going to pass? But then I kept saying, nope, knock it out. You got this. You're going to do well. You're a rock star. So to finally have that, you know, LCSW behind my name is very, very, you know, it's a cool thing. I'm still waiting for my plaque to actually come in. Because I've been told that you get a little one, well, from the state that I live in, you get a little one, and then you get a big one that you can put on your wall. So I'm super excited and to say that, you know, I've been able to cross this accomplishment off my list, because these have been a long 4 years trying to obtain this LCSW exam. So for all of you individuals out there who are just feeling a little down, I'm hoping that my video encouraged and motivated you. Because I normally talk about hair, but I definitely want you guys to kind of look at a different element of it. But you got it. It doesn't matter if you're taking for the LCSW exam, LMSW exam or LGSW exam. You got this. You're very smart. You're competent. You can do it. So with that being said, until next time, National Nikki DST, you guys want me to do more videos like this? Please let me know and I will. All right, talk to you guys soon. Bye.